So I want to make this very human. This is the story of the first time I got into business and how it all went. This is the first time I'm telling this story in a public setting, and I think it's a story that I should own, and one that it should be told. The situation in my life changed me completely as a human. So in 2017, I took the Rich Dad Poor Dad course. Sort of that time was sort of like my own self-awareness journey. I realized that I could be an entrepreneur and that I actually liked that idea, that it resonated with me a lot. At the time, I had minimal debt, I had a stable job, and I was in Phoenix, Arizona. Upon finishing the course, I was very eager to buy a house, to buy a property, and be able to flip it. I was too in love with the money, not in love with the process. And that's where my sort of first misstep happened. I also believe that I wasn't taught well about the risk of real estate. I bought a house in Mesa, Arizona, 4-bedroom, 2-bathroom house that needed a lot of upgrades. I bit more than I could chew. I should have gone for a house that needed less upgrades. It could have been a quicker, easier flip for my first flip, but I decided to go all in because I wanted to see a big return. A couple of things happened. First of all, the market cooled down between when I bought the house and when I wanted to sell it. I didn't do a good job doing my due diligence and the cost of the repairs, plus all the additional costs that come with owning a home and flipping a house. And then the contractor that I was working with did not do a good job, and I wasn't really good at managing him on the quality of his work. I trusted too much. And so what originally was supposed to return my investment and then give me an extra $30,000 gain ended up being an $80,000 loss. I got a hard money loan. Hard money loans are very high interest rate loans, about 20% I think was my interest rate. I got the original money from unsecured lines of credit, meaning credit cards, and I did cash advances, so I had actual cash that I could use to flip this house, buy the house, so on and so forth. And what it should have been a 3-month hold on a house that was bought wholesale, meaning a house that was sold before it hit the MLS retail market, then it ended up being a 9-month project. The real estate agent that I was working with was not able to sell the house, and so I took things into my own hands after a lot of stress, after running out of money, after all these hiccups that kept coming through. It was just like a nightmare, that a snowball effect that just started to unravel, and everything that could go less than ideal did go that way. And I ended up selling the house 9 months later to this website called Open Door. I ended up getting a lot more than I was expecting that I would get, and ended up with $10,000 in my business bank account. But those $10,000 only lasted me a couple months because I had so much debt at that point. Thankfully, I didn't get foreclosed, though I was very close to getting foreclosed. That's where the sort of recovery started. So I sold the house in April of 2018. I was harassed by banks because I was late on all my payments until I enrolled with National Debt Relief. So for the last 3.5-4 years almost, I've been paying this debt off, and from a total $80,000 of debt that I got myself in, I am about $8,000 away from paying that off. So super excited about that. I can tell this story a lot more relaxed and not so much negative energy anymore. At one point I couldn't even talk about it because I was so ashamed of it, but this story changed me for good. It taught me so much as to how to approach business, risk mitigation, going into any business deal with a cool head, looking at the numbers, doing the due diligence, and not being in love with the money, but actually being in love with the process of getting from where you are to where you want to be. That was huge. Though it was the most stressful time of my life, I had 2 panic attacks. This experience is something that I'm super grateful for. It's not something I want to repeat ever again in my life. No matter how good or bad one does in business, life goes on and things can get solved with time. And thank you for watching. Thank you for listening. I hope that if you are an aspiring entrepreneur, you get some inspiration from it. If you are just a friend, then now you know Mario a little bit better. And remember, anything in this life can be overcome.